Hey everybody, VentureForth here! So today guys, we are back in another Minecraft challenge. This one is gonna be pretty interesting. So as of right now, everything might seem totally normal, but anytime I take any points of damage, I receive Levitation 100. And actually, I think I'm gonna die here. So honestly, my goal in this is just to see how far we can make it when every time we receive damage, we just get shot up into the sky. It's gonna be crazy. So we're gonna start off with the usual stuff, collecting some wood, collecting some tools, all that kind of things. And what I really want to do is get my hands on a water bucket as soon as possible, because I have a feeling we're gonna need to be doing MLG water bucket stuff a lot this challenge. And I've gotta say, after our last challenge, I am very much appreciating how easy it is to collect things like stone. So like I said, I want a water bucket, and for that we're gonna need iron. I don't know if these mountains are tall enough, but I've learned from playing Minecraft in the newer versions, getting up really high on a mountain, you can find an insane amount of iron, like really quick. But the mountain has to be tall enough. And there's probably other requirements I don't know about. But we're gonna be risky here. We're gonna check the top of this mountain and see if there is iron up there, because that could make things go a lot quicker. Actually, you know what? We might be able to get up that mountain a little bit faster. Oh, this was a mistake. Oh, this was a mistake. I didn't realize. Oh, there is iron. There is iron up there. Okay, yeah, that one was my bad. I just kind of forgot just how high 100 levitation sends you, but there was iron up there, so the plan was solid, just not as much the launching myself to my death part. That part was a mistake. And here's all of our stuff back. That was not too bad. Let's not do that again though. But this here is the iron I spotted as we were plummeting to our death. So look at that, we already have iron. Oh dang it! No! Wait, water, maybe? Oh gosh. And here we are, a bucket and some water. So, we at least have the chance to save ourselves. I'm not great at MLG water bucket stuff, but at least we have the chance. Now, I do want to get some iron for armor. It won't help stop us from getting launched into the air, because really all that the game is checking for is if I'm getting, like, damage dealt. However, I do believe that armor helps reduce the amount of fall damage you take. So if we end up in a situation where we like just barely don't survive without armor, armor might be enough to allow us to survive a large fall. I kind of want to go up onto these mountains still and like look inside those caves and things, because I'm hopeful for more iron. Plus, being inside caves is a lot safer for us, because if we end up getting hurt, we just get sent right up to the ceiling. And mobs are spawning. This could be bad. My biggest fear is skeletons, because a skeleton shooting us with an arrow is gonna be kind of devastating. Okay, I lost the ability to sprint. Oh no! Okay, come on. I can do this. Oh boy. To be honest, I'm really not sure what to do about our food situation right now. I haven't really seen any good. No, stop it, no. Wait, what? Okay, apparently even if it hits my shield, it's still enough to trigger the levitation. Stop. Okay, I'll be honest, I did not expect that even my shield getting hit would trigger levitation. That's gonna be a problem. Okay, I'm almost back to our stuff. If we can get indoors, we'll be a lot safer. Okay, I don't see the skeleton. Gonna immediately put my water bucket here. Ooh, there's iron. All right, well that was a bit terrifying, but I still wanna try and claim this cave as ours. So we're gonna start by blocking off this for now so we can't get attacked from up there. And I've lit up a good amount of this area so that I think mobs, oh, close that off. I think we should be pretty safe from mobs in here, so I kinda wanna make this like our base of operations. Cause again, being indoors is gonna help us a lot in this challenge. Now, while it's daylight as well, we should really try and figure out a good food source. Because again, I have not seen many options for food out here. I see a large looking like plains biome out there. We should head out that way and see if we can get some food, or even just stuff to grow crops if we have to. I did actually manage to get some flint, and we have one more piece of iron, so I'm gonna make us a flint and steel as well, because that is sometimes just really nice to have on hand. This is what we're going to be careful of. I want to get cooked meat from them, but if I accidentally touch that fire, it's gonna be bad for me. Oh, finally, food. Oh, dang it! I fell a little bit too much. Okay, I think this river is unfrozen, this part. Yeah. Okay. I gotta be more careful about that. Oh, dang it! I knew this would happen if I used a flint and steel. I knew I'd end up launching myself into the air. Oh, dang it! I gotta stop doing that, my gosh. Really hard to aim a flint and steel properly. Okay. That's fine. I'll be back there in a few minutes. All right, let's go ahead and sleep here and hopefully stop most mobs from spawning. Might be a little late to have stopped all of them, but that should at least help us. All right, I think we should be set for a little while on food. I collect quite a bit of cooked food thanks to our flint and steel. So I'm gonna head back to our base and start kind of getting a more permanent living situation set up. Home sweet home, here we are. So now that our inventory is cleared out, I'm gonna take the risky route and attempt actually exploring all this stuff that's connected to us. Okay, there's a zombie. Actually sounds like there are a lot of mobs that have spawned down here for some reason. This could get tricky. Ah, skeleton! Okay, fight each other, fight each other. And I'm gonna help clean up that skeleton because I don't wanna fight him. There we go. Awesome, and now that we have some iron, I can make some shears because there's something I wanted to do. You guys may have seen this little thing I built up here in the front of our base. That is because I would like to have some snow golem guardians to help keep mobs out of here. We'll go ahead and pop this one here, and this- oh, whoops. That's a very hunchbacked snow golem. Alright, what I meant to do is right there. And there we go. So now, if the hope goes correctly, if a mob tries to approach our entrance here, these guys will keep him at bay. There we go. Well, it's not the most exciting farm in the world, but this should help us out if we ever start having food issues in the future. So got that done. That'll be nice. So now that we've got ourselves a little bit more settled at our base, I want to start taking a look around the neighbor- Oh! Wait! Why do I have no water in my- Oh no, I used it on the farm! Ah! Okay, well, fortunately we died right outside of our base. Also, unfortunately, that means that I'm capable of dying mere seconds after stepping outside, so that's a confidence booster to be sure. I think you really don't realize how often you take small amounts of damage in Minecraft until you're punished every single time it happens. And then it's like, oh my gosh. So what I was trying to say earlier is I want to explore the neighborhood, or AKA the area around our base, to look for caves, because I would like to get some diamonds to make a diamond pickaxe and go to the nether. Now last time we did a challenge, I did learn a very slow, awkward way to make a nether portal, so we could do that if need be, but I think it'd be fun to actually get a diamond pickaxe. And I did also see that we found a village, like right near where we live. So that was handy. Do they have anything for me to loot? Okay, this guy has some stuff. Some soup, some coal. I'll take the coal and the bread. For now, I'm gonna leave everything else in here because I don't really care that much about it. Nothing super exciting in this village, but that does mean we have farms nearby that they've already made, which is handy. Ah, dang it. Okay, whatever, I should be fine. Oh, you know what this area makes me want to do? How can you see something like this and not use a boat on it? Look how fast we're moving. Oh, this is fun. I'm realizing how barren the wastes of the ice can be. Not a whole lot to see, which is unfortunate. Ooh, could this be a helpful cave for us to explore? It looks like this cave goes pretty deep. We might be able to get some good stuff in here. Guys, I was lied to. This cave looks all dramatic and then it just stops right here. That's the dead end. What? Come on. All right, hold on. I want to try this properly this time. So I want to get up there quickly. So if I take a little bit of fall damage. Oh, it's actually harder than I thought it'd be. Take a little bit of fall damage. What? Take a little bit of fall damage. There we go. And then I just come up here. That So it slipped my mind that when you hit the ground, you take damage again and you get launched back up again. So I wasn't ready with my water bucket in time. And there's my stuff back. You know what? I think I've decided to stop trying to use levitation to my advantage because I am not very good at it. Is it stray? No! Why? Why? I was almost home! Wait, no, I can still do this. Why am I so bad at the water bucket? Funny thing is, I was right about to say, well, we somehow managed to make it home without incident, but I was like, you know what? I should probably wait until I'm literally in the door before saying that. That is why. Oh, that startled me. I thought he was about to attack me. Ah! Oh, hey! Thank you, guys. They kept the Enderman out. Alright, it's gonna be a bit slow going, but I think it's about time I try and do this the old-fashioned way. Dig very far down and strip mine for a bit, and hopefully hit a cave way down here, but the caves around here are not going as deep as I'd like for what I'm able to discover, so I'm just gonna do it the old way. Ooh, okay, I'm down pretty low, down to like 30 or so, and I just stumbled into a cave, so this could be good for us. I'm gonna put this water bucket here and actually leave it here because I think I see more water I can grab. And that way we can easily get up and down this if, you know, something tragic happens. I know I heard a creeper land right next to me. Where? Ah! That startled me. Nice thing about water is that levitation doesn't affect you when you're in the water. I mean, you still gain the effect. It just won't make you rise up at all. Ah! Come on! Where are all these creepers coming from? Why is there more? We're gonna fight in the water for a minute because I'm safe in the water. Well, I'm still relatively safe in the water. No! Well, this is the advantage of having made a staircase down there. We can just climb down for a bit. Okay, I'm gonna have to be careful because I saw two creepers and a spider. We killed the spider. The first creeper blew up and I never saw the second creeper blow up. So he's probably waiting for us down there. Very carefully, but very quickly, grab all of my loots. Yeah, there's the other creeper. He was waiting for us. Not cool, man. Come on. Okay, let's try again to very carefully explore this death trap. Wait, that's a zombie spawner. That's cobblestone. What are the odds? Oh, dang it. Oh, no, 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 no. Okay. All right, lit up. Let's see what we got in here. Okay, we got two of the exact same music disc. What is the odds of that? All right, not too bad. We got a saddle and some iron horse armor. We got a golden apple in case we need that for some reason. All right, all of our goodies have been safely put away, so they should be safe. We're gonna get some better armor, and then we should be good to get back to it. We are now fully geared out, all iron armor. I upgraded our sword, made a backup pickaxe, all that good stuff. We are ready to get back to trying to find some diamonds. Also, we don't need it, but I was heading back over here and I just noticed this block here, which, if I remember correctly, means there is a geode hiding back here. Yes, there is. Take a look at that. Again, I really don't need any of these blocks for anything. But I just wanted to comment on the fact that that means there is a geode that spawned right next to a dungeon. That's pretty cool. No way. Guys, there is another spawner here. I've literally been searching for like a few minutes and we've already discovered another dungeon. Are you kidding me? The same music disc. Again, I haven't been collecting them because I don't plan on making a jukebox, but that is the third cat disc we've found. What is up with that? Uh-oh. This can get bad fast. If I move towards him, I'll start taking damage, which I don't want. So I need him to come up to me. Oh boy. This is really tough to fight with being launched into the air constantly. Okay, I have been looking forever trying to find diamonds and just cannot find any. But I am now in this huge, giant deep. Oh, there it is! I was gonna say there's no possible way there's not diamonds somewhere in here. Even then, when I finally find some, they're like hidden almost under this water stream, which I'm trying to get rid of. Hello? Anyways, what I was trying to say is I knew we would have to find diamonds somewhere in here. I need at least three. One, two. Well, that's kind of annoying. Wait, I think there's more over here. Is that diamonds? There we go. That's at least three diamonds now in total. Wow, it's literally just three. Perfect. We now have a diamond pickaxe. And I saw a lava pool right over here, if I remember correctly. Yep, There it is. I have just finished collecting the obsidian that we need for the portal. So let's head back up to our base and go ahead and make this. Okay, so I'm realizing we're unfortunately not going to be able to use our water bucket in the nethers. So I'm going to leave it there. We are going to take this boat because I think what you can do is place down a boat and get in it right before you hit the ground. And it's a lot harder to do, but I think it's possible. So that's going to be our only hope, honestly. We're going to go ahead and light this. Perfect. And let's find out what awaits us on the other side. Hopefully it's a good spawn. Oh, interesting. This is an incredibly dangerous spawn. That's not though. Crimson Forest is dangerous, but a Warp Forest spawns like nothing. I've never seen this. I didn't know baby Striders ride on top of regular Striders. That is honestly just adorable. I love that so much. Nothing but Endermen can spawn in the Warp Forest, so we should be pretty safe in there. You know, if we had Ender Pearls, we could potentially save our life in here with Ender Pearls too. Like throw them down to the ground before we get hurt. Wait, what? Oh, he just started suffocating. Let's finish him off so we get the drop. I just realized something. When you throw an Ender Pearl, you take a little bit of fall damage when it hits. So really, it could still save us because I might be able to like position myself under a tree or something. They're not worthless, but I just remembered they're not as good as I'd hoped. Guys, I just realized something. We have access to warped fungus. We have a saddle. We have Striders right here. But yeah, we have everything we need to be able to ride a Strider. So we should do that. And here we go. Fishing rod, warped fungus. Warped fungus on a stick. Perfect. And the saddle that we need. So we can actually ride a Strider. That'll make exploring the nether way easier. Oh, he's right here. Come here, come here. Oh, we're doing it! Oh, this is the way to travel through the nether. I should have been doing this in the past. Oh, hey, look! This right here is just a couple of lads commuting to work. No way. Is that a bastion? I feel like we gotta go big or go home, right? It's actually kind of terrifying not knowing where these things are hanging out. Oh no, he's got arrows! Well, so do I, loser. Oh, that brute just fell into the lava. Well, that worked out nice for me. I don't know how to loot these things. Where are the chests? Oh, admittedly, this does seem like one of the worst chests to go for because it's all the way down here. I'd like to acknowledge this will be a bad idea. I'd also like to acknowledge I'm gonna try it anyways. Why can't I climb this? Why can't I climb this? No! I just wanted to know what was in there. Well, guys, I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it there. I don't think I'm gonna make it back to all that stuff, unfortunately, and that just kind of reset pretty much everything we've done. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, subscribe if you want to stay updated on all of my videos that I'm posting, and as always, I want to thank you guys for watching. See ya!